clean over here because Mark did sort of have to see a victory slip through his hands, and it looks like he's lost his spot again, but it ain't over until it's over. This battle, I think, will make him feel at least, well, but right now, it's really, everyone's just fighting for a position because it's a very part of the race. You want to gain as much position as
you can. And speaking of gaining position advantage, Rick, you are getting a little more gap.
A little more gap. Mark Silk also dropped down 1, 2, 3, 4 places. He's now in 5th place.
Long, and now in 3rd place.
3rd place for Eddie Young and number 6 for 6.
And
you know what, honestly, as John, I'm not being That's the big point. Exactly the same accident. You notice that car is coming back into the track that he hit John Neeson. John stopped it. But remember, that was in the drive. So I don't think Troy would have probably lost it. He would probably have enough grip to be able to save it. But the thing is, in the wet, the same thing happens and you can't remove it. It's a very scary planet. Very, very scary. It's playing with five
metaphors. Yes.
Four hearts, five.
Lord, Mark.
It brings me close to this general public at all.
Well, I mean, if they overrated the rear car ownership to everybody, their accessibility and their pricing and their value for money, it stands to reason to bring people close to the racing using the same formula. This is what they're all about. They are just a brand that's really, like, it's not just about building cars, it's just about building communities. And in this case, it's a racing community, and look at the dividends it's paid. I mean, it's just, we've seen some great careers being born out of this.